I heard about the film. I heard that there was a young guy doing a feature-length film at a sister church to my church, and it was Kyle. The opportunity came forth. It almost to me seemed like there wasn't anybody else, and that Kyle was going to need the help. If you know, if we look at the components of a quality film. Visually, you've got to have good photography, good cinematography, and good lighting. And I realized that, and I knew that if Kyle didn't have the right person doing the lighting, it could sink the film. So I said, I'll do it. Maybe what I could do is just come in as a consultant, get you started, get you up to speed, show you how to do it so you can be able to do it yourself. And that all sounded good, but when push came to shove, I could see that, you know, Kyle was juggling eight balls already in the air, being a cameraman, being a director, trying to never shooting a film. I mean, here's a guy that took a feature-length film as his first major project. I mean, most people would tell you that that's absolutely insane. The two-man crew was fun. It was a lot of fun at times. We had a lot of laughs over it. You know, I'd get done lighting a set, and I'd pick up the boom, and Kyle would hand me the headphones, sometimes, sometimes not, you know, and we got it done. We just got it done. And it was nice to be able to work with a young man who had a quality eye that made me work as hard as I could to get quality lighting to match it. And I've been shooting, you know, stills, and I've been on other film sets before, shooting stills for years, and this is a different atmosphere, you know, working on a Christian film. We're human, we have our weaknesses and our frailties, but, you know, we overcome them with the love of Christ, and that's the cool thing about it. I don't think anybody can ask anymore, is God familiar with my suffering, or why did bad things happen, when he himself took the most wicked thing that could have happened in this world, and that is the murder of his son in such a heinous way, and turned it into such a phenomenal blessing for everybody. What man intends for evil, God will use for good, the Bible says. It's a fascinating statement. So what's going on with Dave here and Stephen in the film? It's the same story again. God can take the worst part of our suffering and turn it into an awesome blessing. That's what he specializes in. And that's, there is no greater story than that.